kids would hear the groan of the zombie-like people roaming the streets and the shrieks of bats and living nightmares. In Bloodsville, there was an old haunted library, which had been owned by the founder of Bloodsville and was the creepiest place there. The current librarian was 200 years old and had gray skin and 7 fingers on each hand. She would throw exploding books at you if you dared to make a peep. She ate kids who didn't return their books on time. Olivia, who was the youngest of all the Brown children, had a book report assigned by her half-zombie teacher, and she needed a book to read. She had no books, so it was the library or nothing. The children always stuck together, so they went all to the library with Olivia. They trembled with fear as they walked up the library's creepy steps. Frank was the oldest, so it was his job to open the door. "Olivia, why don't you just skip the assignment? This place is scary," Frank said. If you skip an assignment, the teacher bites you." "I'm not doing that," Olivia said. "Just use one of our books," suggested Callie. "Sorry," said Olivia. "We didn't bring any books, remember?" So in they went. They entered the library. Blood stained the walls and floor. Olivia went over to the fiction section and the others followed. She opened a book called The Pumpkin Guts. It sounded at least scary, but when she opened the book, she screamed. It had worms and bugs crawling all over the pages. It smelled like dead fish. Ashton almost fainted, but then Frank let out a squeak and they saw the librarian. She cackled and threw an exploding book at them. Ashton was too scared to move, and it almost hit him. But at the last second, Callie pulled him away. They ran for their lives, but they could not reach the door because the librarian had blocked it. They ran the other way towards a door marked basement. They probably shouldn't have gone down there, but they did anyway. "Smells like death down there," said Olivia. "How do you know what death smells like?" said Frank. "Because we live in Bloodsville. Death is everywhere," answered Olivia. They heard a hiss and then a scream. Callie was gone. "Where's Callie?" asked Ashton. They heard a scream again, and a horrible, ugly creature came out of the shadows. It had a giant, snake-like body, but from the waist up, it looked like a human. An ugly, evil, horrible human with sharp fangs. A slither. Frank had read about them in books. Blood dripped out of its mouth, and it hissed again. The creature looked hungrily at the three children. They froze like they were trying to turn invisible. The slither closed its eyes like it was singing "Eeny, meeny, miny, moe" to find out what child to eat first. The kids seized this opportunity to find Callie. They ran. They saw a very faint light and ran to it. It was coming from a small room that smelled like, as Olivia would say, like death. Callie was on the floor, curled up in a ball, tears streaming down her cheeks and blood dripping down her arm. "Callie, we found you! What happened to you?" Ashton cried. Callie whimpered and shut her eyes. The slither bit me and I just looked into that crystal ball." Three children ran over to the crystal ball and sat on a bloody pedestal and looked in. The fog swirled in it and they heard a faint voice come from it. "Listen, all of you. Feeling scared today? Frights and scares in every room and in every hallway? See them and hear them, fear them. When near them, they will make you scream. There's no escape. Do you think you're in a dream? You can't escape by sundown. You'll be drilled into the ground." "Did you hear that?" asked Callie, sitting up. "Yeah," said Frank. "So we got to escape before sundown." He checked his watch. "We have half an hour to escape." Callie stood up. "Are you okay, Callie?" asked Olivia, grabbing a tissue from her pocket and giving it to Callie. "Yeah, I'm good. Come on, let's go." The four children ran out of the room and into the darkness. The Slither was nowhere to be seen. They ran farther into the darkness, and hoping to avoid being caught by the Slither, they ran and they ran. Olivia was in front, and Frank was in the back. Suddenly, Olivia stopped cold. "Why are you stopping? The Slither's going to catch us," said Frank. "Well, first of all, we have no idea where we're going. And second of all, that." Olivia pointed upward, and there stood a monster. It looked like a pile of slime, and its remains of its last meal were stuck to it. It smelled like month-old bologna. Whenever it moved, slime squirted out of its body. It was big and gray and scary. Then it roared a roar so loud it shook the whole town. "Monster!" yelled Ashton. "Giant!" yelled Collie. "Godzilla!" yelled Frank. And they all started running. The thing chased them towards the stairs, and they were surrounded. The librarian on the left, the Slither behind them, and the thing in front of them, and on the right was a wall. "1 minute till sundown," screamed Frank. The librarian was coming closer and trapping them against the wall. The second hand on Frank's watch ticked, and then it was 7:50, sundown. So they had failed. They couldn't escape. So this was the end. The children awoke in their own house in Grinning City, in their own beds, unharmed. "I don't want to die," screamed Frank, who was still in his dream. "Don't eat me," he shouted. Olivia woke next, and she yelled, "Don't let me die." Callie was screaming in her sleep, and Ashton was yelling, "No, no, no!" Their mother came in. "Silly little children," she said, "you're having a nightmare." They were breathing heavily, and they were very scared. "Where are we?" said Ashton. "We're in Grinning City, in our own house." "You silly kids," said their mother. "What about Bloodsville?" asked Callie. "Bloodsville? Who ever heard of Bloodsville?" "You were dreaming." Their mother walked out. Maybe they were dreaming, but a small part of it still seemed very real. They stood up and walked out of the room. They went downstairs to eat breakfast. Olivia got the cereal and milk and sat them on the table. Callie poured the cereal into her bowl and started to eat. "Callie, pass the box. We're hungry too," said Frank. Callie smiled, and in her mouth were fangs. Big ones, like the Slithers. She grabbed Ashton's arm and bit down.